morning, everyone. We are back on the Racecourse Stadium, recording live on SBC TV. So after the first match, we are here with the second, and it's going to be kind of special because the hosting country, Sri Lanka, is going to perform today. And it's after a turbulent last year. We are here with the Sri Lankan boys. And of course, we have Papua New Guinea with us, competing with us today. And hopefully, it's going to be a groundbreaking tournament today. So, inviting all to join this moment as the atmosphere is already getting hot here. And of course, I can smell the excitement, the sportsmanship. It's all in the air. So, inviting everybody. Here we go to start the final match for the day. By congratulating both the teams, let's start the final match. And I would like to invite the Sri Lankan crowd. Ithin mang aadarin illanawa hamotama aaradhana karana papada saddete ape Lankawa kollonda support karanna ekathu wenna kiyala. Ithin etekama mam chamota baara denawa oge kathawa karanna.
අයිබෝවන් සුබ සන්ධ්‍යාවක් ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරනවා ඔබට. අපි සෝදානම් කොළඹ තුරග තරග පිටියේ සිට මේ ආකාරයෙන් ඊළඟ තරගයේ සජීව තොරතුරුත් එක්ක එකතු වෙන්න. ඉතින් විශේෂයෙන්ම කලින් තරගයේ නිමා වුණාට පස්සේ ඊළඟට ආරම්භ වෙන සෝදානම් වෙලා තියෙනවා තීරණාත්මක තරගයේ. මේ තීරණාත්මක තරගයේ තමයි ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායම සහ පැපුවා නිව් ගිනියානු කණ්ඩායම අතර තරගය. ඉතින් අපි කලින් මතක් කරපු ආකාරයට මේ FIFA සීරීස් තරගාවලියේ අද දිනේ ක්‍රියාත්මක වන දෙවන තරගය තමයි මේ ආකාරයෙන් ආරම්භ වෙන සෝදානම් වෙලා තියෙන්නේ. ඉතින් තරගයේ ආරම්භයට කලින් අපි සෝදානම් වෙලා ඉන්නවා විශේෂ කතා බහක නිරත වෙන්න. ඉතින් අපි ආරාධනා කරා ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සංගමයේ උපසභාපති වෛද්‍ය මනිල් ෆර්නෑන්ඩ් මහතාට අයිබෝවන් සුබ සන්ධ්‍යාවක් කියලා ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරනවා බුදුමන්ට. මම හිතන්නේ මේ තීරණාත්මක තරගය කාලයකට පස්සේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ පාපන්දු තහනම් වුණාට පස්සේ අපි අවසන් තරග කිහිපයක් ක්‍රීඩා කරලා අවසානයේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේදී කාලයකට පස්සේ අපිට ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායම ක්‍රීඩා කරන තරගයක් නරඹන්න හැකියාවක් ලැබිලා තියෙනවා. ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ උපසභාපතිවරයා විදිහට මම දැනගත්තේ මොනවාගේ සතුටක්ද තියෙන්නේ මේ තරගාවලියේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ පැවැත්වීම මේ වගේම සත්කාරක රාජ්‍යලා ඉනවා තරගාවලියේ පළමු තරගයේ ක්‍රීඩා කරන්න.
මේක විදියට මේක අපිට ලැබුණ ලොකු දායාදයක්. අපේ සභාපතිතුමා ලෝක පාපන්දුවේ සභාපතිතුමත් එක්ක සාකච්ඡාවකට අනතුරුව මේ FIFA සීරීස් එක ලංකාවේ පවත්වන්න තීරණය කෙරුවා. ඒක මං හිතන්නේ අපිට අපි මොකද අපි බලයට ආවන් පස්සේ කෙටි කාලයක් තුළ අපිට යෙමන් රාජ්‍යයත් එක්ක ක්‍රීඩා කරන්න වුණා. ඔවුන් 50ක් අපිට ඉස්සරහින් හිටියේ. අපිට කණ්ඩායම සකස් කරගන්න කෙටි කාලයක් තිබුණේ. ඒකින්ද ඒ අපහසුතාවයත් මත අපිට අවශ්‍ය තැනට අපිට එන්න ඒ අවස්ථාවේදී බැරි වුණත් මං හිතන්නේ මේ අවස්ථාව අපිට ලොකු අපේ පාපන්දුව ඉදිරියට ගෙනියන්න අපේ ගමන ආරම්භ කරන්න මං හිතන්නේ පළවෙනි අඩිය තමයි මේ තියන්න හදන්නේ.
මගදන මේ වගේ තරගාවලියක් ශ්‍රී ලංකාවට ලැබෙනම කාලයකට පස්සේ ඒ වගේම අපි කතා කරොත් එහෙම අපි අර ජාත්‍යන්තර මට්ටමේ පාපන්දු තරගාවලියක අත්දැකීම් දකිනවා ශ්‍රී ලංකාව තුළදී මේ තරගාවලියේදී. මම දැනගන්න කැමතියි මේ ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ මේ වගේ තරගාවලියක් සංවිධානය කරද්දී ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ මොන වගේ දායකත්වයක්ද ලැබුණේ අන්තර්ජාතික පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ?
මම හිතන්නේ අන්තර්ජාතික පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ අපිට සම්පූර්ණ දායකත්වයක් ලැබුණා. ඒක ලැබෙන්නේ නැතුව මං හිතන්නේ නැහැ අපිට මේ කෙටි කාලයක් තුළ මේක සංවිධානය කරන්න කියලා කියලා. අපිට මේ වගේ මේ ටෝර්නමන්ට් එකක් ලංකාවේ සංවිධානය කරන්න බොහොම අමාරුයි. මොකද අපිට අවශ්‍ය ලෝක පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ මට්ටමේ තියෙන අවශ්‍ය ප්‍රතිපදාන ලංකාවේ නැහැ. ඉතින් ඒක කෙටි කාලයක් තුළ සකස් කරන්න මං හිතන්නේ අපේ සභාපතිතුමා ඇතුළු කණ්ඩායම ගොඩක් වෙහෙසිලා තමයි මේක මේ මට්ටමට අරගත්තේ.
ඒ වගේම මේ මම දැනගන්න කැමතියි මනිල් ෆර්නෑන්ඩ් මහත්මයාගෙන් දැන් ඊළඟ තරගයේ තීරණාත්මක තරගයක් මොකද ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායම තමයි ක්‍රීඩා කරන්නේ. දැන් අද දවසේ පළමු තරගයේ පැවැතුණා මධ්‍ය අප්‍රිකාව සහ බූතාන් අතර තරගය. ඉන්පස්සේ තරගයට මම හිතන්නේ ක්‍රීඩාංගණයට සුළු වර්ෂාවක් ඇති වුණා. හැබැයි මේ වෙද්දී මේ වර්ෂාව මේ සියල්ල මම හිතන්නේ ක්‍රීඩාංගණයේ තිබු වතුර පවා මේ සියල්ල දේ ඉවත් කරලා මේ වෙද්දී තරගයට සියල්ල සූදානම් කරලා තියෙන්නේ. තීරණාත්මක තරගයක් ශ්‍රී ලංකාව සහ පැපුවා නිව් ගිනියානු කණ්ඩායම අතර. මම දැනගන්න කැමතියි ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායමේ සංයුතිය මොනවාගේ විදිහකට සකස් වෙයිද? මොකද අපිට කාලයකට පස්සේ මම හිතන්නේ ශ්‍රී ලංකා ප්‍රේක්ෂකයන් ගණනාවක් මේ වෙද්දී තරගයේ සජීවීව නරඹනවා. ඒ වගේම ටෙලිවිෂනේ නරඹනවා වගේම මේ වෙද්දී බොහෝ ප්‍රේක්ෂකයන් සංඛ්‍යාවක් කොළඹ තුරග තරග පිටියට ඇවිල්ලා ඉන්නවා. ඉතින් ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායම මොනවාගේ තරගයක් ලබා දේවිද?
මහිතන්නේ ලංකාව හොඳ තරගයක් ලබා දේවි. මම බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා අපි ලංකාව අද ජයග්‍රහණය කරයි කියලා. අඩුම වශයෙන් ගෝල දෙකක බිංදුවක පරතරයකින්. හැබැයි අපි ක්‍රීඩා කරන්නේ අපේ ගත විශේෂ විදේශීය එනිගත වීමේ අපි 204 ටීම්නේ. පැපුවා නිව් ගිනිය 160 ට ඉන්නේ. ඒතර යම්සි පරතරයක් තියෙනවා. හැබැයි පළවෙනි වතාවට ලංකාවට 14 දෙනෙක් අනියුක්ත කරලා තියෙනවා පිටරටින්. ඒගොල්ලන් ඉංගලන්තයේ, ස්වීඩනයේ, ජර්මනියේ, හොංකොං වල, ඕස්ට්‍රේලියාවේ වැනි රටවල් වල උඩ මට්ටමක ක්‍රීඩා කරන ක්‍රීඩකයන් ලංකාවේ ලේ තියෙන ක්‍රීඩකයන්. ඉතින් අපි බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ අනියුක්ත වීමත් සමග අපේ ලංකාවේ ක්‍රීඩකයන් අතර බැඳීමත් සමග අද හොඳ තරගයක් දීලා හොඳ ජයග්‍රහණයක් ලබයි.
ඒ වගේම මම දැනගන්න කැමතියි මේ මම කිව්ව විදිහට තවත් ප්‍රධාන කාරණයක් තමයි අපි කියන අර ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ සම්භවයක් සහිත ක්‍රීඩකයන් කිහිප දෙනෙක් 14 දෙනෙක් ආසන සංඛ්‍යාවක් ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායම නියෝජනය කරන්න ලෑස්තිලා ඉන්නවා. කාලයකට පස්සේ තමන්ගේ මව රට වෙනුවෙන් ක්‍රීඩා කරනවා. මම හිතන්නේ මේ ක්‍රීඩකයන් ගණනාව يعني අපි කියන ලංකාවට ගෙනල්ලා ඕන ශ්‍රී ලංකා ජාතික කණ්ඩායම දක්වා ක්‍රීඩා කරන තැනට ගෙනාවේ වත්මන් සභාපතිතුමා නැතුව ඔබලාගේ කාර්ය මණ්ඩලය මම දැනගන්න කැමතියි. මේ මම හිතන්නේ ලොකු අපහසුතාවයන් ගණනාවකුත් එක්ක තමයි මේ ගමන එන්නේ නැත්තේ. ඒ වගේම මේ ක්‍රීඩකයන් ලංකාවේදී දැන් අපි කියන බිත්තු පොලිසිය භාවය ලබා දීමේදී MC ගැටළු මතුවුණාද? මේ ගැටළු නිරාකරණය කරගන්න සංගමයක් විදිහට ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපොන්දු සම්මේලනයේ මොන වගේ පියවරක්ද ගත්තේ?
මම හිතන්නේ මේක අවුරුදු 4ක විතර කාලයක් තිස්සේ ලංකාව ලංකා පාපොන්දු සම්මේලනයේ මේකට ගොඩක් වෙහෙසෙනවා. හැබැයි ඒක වැඩි සාර්ථකත්වයක් තිබුණේ නැහැ මෑත කාලයක් වෙනකම්. මම හිතන්නේ මේ අවස්ථාවේදී මම ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙන්න ඕනේ ශ්‍රී ලංකා ජනාධිපතිතුමාටත්, ටිරනලස් අමාත්‍යතුමාටත්, අපේ ඉමිග්‍රේෂන් කන්ට්‍රෝලර් මැතිතුමාටත්. මොකද එතුමන්ලාගේ සහයෝගය නැතුව අපිට මේ ළමයින්ව මෙච්චර ඉක්මනට මේ තැනට ගේන්න බැරි වෙනවා. කෙටි කාලයක් තුළදී අපි මේ තත්ත්වයට ගෙනාවේ. අනිත් එක අපේ ප්‍රේක්ෂකයෝ දැනගන්න ඕනේ අපි මේ ළමයින්ව තෝරගද්දී මේ නිකම්ම මේ ඇවිල්ලා පිට රටින් ආපු ළමයි ටිකක් එක්ක අහු වෙලා විදිත ප්‍රවාසී භාවය ලබා දුන්නේ නැහැ. අපි කටාරාජ්‍යයේ ස්පයර් අකඩමියක් එක්ක අහු වෙලා මේ ළමයින් මොන මොන තත්ත්වෙද සෙල්ලම් කරන්නේ, මොන මට්ටමේද සෙල්ලම් කරන්නේ, කොයි තැන්වලද සෙල්ලම් කරන්නේ, අපිට ඒක අවශ්‍යද, ඒ තැන්වල අපිට හිඩස් තියෙනවද, ඒවා පුරවන්න ඕනේද, ඒ ඔක්කොම කරලා තමයි මේ ළමයින්ව මේ තත්ත්වයට ගෙනාවේ. ඉතින් මම හිතනවා ඒ ඉතුමන්ලාටත් ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙන්න ඕනේ අපිට ඒ ලබා දුන්න දායකත්වයට. අපේ සභාපතිතුමායකට ගොඩක් වෙහෙසුණා අපේ විධායක කමිටියත් සමග. මං හිතන්නේ දැන් තියෙන්නේ ඒගොල්ලන් එකට ජෙල් වෙන්නේ කොහොමද මේක වෙන්නේ. මම මේ පළවෙනි වතාවට දකින්නේ මේ කට්ටිය මෙහෙම සෙල්ලම් කරන එකක්. අපේ මේ පළවෙනි අඩිය මං කිව්වා වගේ අපි 20-25 වෙනකන් අපේ ඊළඟ සාප ටෝනමන්ට් එකට තමයි මේක හදාගෙන යන්නේ. මං හිතන්නේ අපි හොඳ ගමනක් අද ආරම්භ කරනවා.
ඒ වගේම දැන් අපි කතා කරපු විදිහට මේ වගේ FIFA තරගාවලියක් මෙවැනි ලෝකේ විශේෂයෙන්ම දැන් මේ දින කිහිපේ පුරාට මේ වගේ මේ වසර පුරාවටම තවත් වන්න සූදානම් වෙලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් ඒකෙන් ශ්‍රී ලංකාව සත්කාරකත්වයෙන් එක් තරගාවලියක් සඳහා තෝරගෙන තියෙනවා. බොහෝ විට මෙය ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ මගේ දැනේ පාපන්දුවල හැරවුම් ලක්ෂයක් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. මේ තරගාවලියෙන් පස්සේ අපි කතා කරන දැන් ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ බොහෝ ක්‍රීඩායි මේ වගේ හැරවුම් ලක්ෂයකුත් එක්ක ජනප්‍රිය වෙන්න පටන් ගත්තා. බොහෝ විට මේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ පාපන්දුවල හැරවුම් ලක්ෂයක් වෙන්න පුළුවන්. ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ විදිහට මේ තරගාවලියේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ පැවැත්වීම සම්බන්ධයෙන් මොන වගේ සතුටක් තියෙනවද?
ඉතින් අපි ගොඩක් සතුටු වෙන්න ඕනේ. මේක අපිට මේක සෞදි අරාබියේ පැවැත්වුවා නම් අපිට හරි ලේසි. අපිට ටිකට් එකක් ලැබෙනවා, අපිට හෝටලයක් ලැබෙනවා, අපිට නිකන් ගිහිල්ලා ගහලා එන්න විතරයි තියෙන්නේ. හැබැයි මේක ලංකාවේ පවත්වන්න ගොඩාක් කට්ටිය වෙහෙසුණා. මේක පවත්වන්න අපිට ලෝක පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයෙන් අපිට ගොඩක් උදව් ලැබුණා. මම හිතන්නේ ලංකාවේ ප්‍රේක්ෂකයන්ට ලංකාව සෙල්ලම් කරලා ඒක අත්දැකීම් ලබන්න අපි ඉඩ දෙන්න ඕනේ. එතකොට තමයි අපිට මේ ලංකාවේ පාපන්දු වල මට්ටම ඉහළට අරන් යන්න පුළුවන්. ඒ සිහිනයෙන් තමයි අපි සභාපතිතුමත් අපේ විධායක කමිටියත් ඉන්නේ. මං හිතන්නේ අපේ ළමයි අද හරියට සෙල්ලම් කෙරුවොත් අපිට අවශ්‍ය අද රිසල්ට් එක ලැබුණොත් මං හිතන්නේ ඒවා කියන විදිහට ඒ පාරේ අපිට යන්න පුළුවන්.
ඒ වගේම අපි දකිනවා මං හිතන්නේ කාලෙකට පස්සේ අර අපි කියන්නේ ජාත්‍යන්තර මට්ටමේ පාපන්දු තරගාවලියක් ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ පැවැත්වෙනවා. අර ඒ විධිවිධාන ඒ ආකාරයෙන්ම ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙනවා. ඒ වගේම ජාත්‍යන්තර මට්ටමේ ප්‍රමිතීන් අනුකූලව තමයි මේ තරගාවලිය මේ ආකාරයෙන් ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙන්නේ. මේ වගේ තරගාවලියක් සංවිධානය කරද්දී ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ විදිහට මොන වගේ ස්ථාවර මට්ටමක හිටියද අපි දකිනවා. මොකද පහුගිය කාල සීමාව පුරාවටම ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ බොහෝ අන්තර්ජාතික මට්ටමේ තරගාවලිය පැවැත්වුණා. හැබැයි අපි දකිනවා මේ තරගාවලිය අර ඉන්ටර්නැෂනල් ලෙවල් එකටම ගිහින් තියෙනවා. ජාත්‍යන්තර පාපන්දු තරගාවලියක් මට්ටමට ගිහින් තියෙනවා. මේ වගේ දේවල් සංවිධානය කරද්දි මොන වගේ තීරණයක හිටියද ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ?
සමුත් මේක පොඩ්ඩක් වෙනස් වෙන තරගාවලියට වඩා. මොකද මෙතෙක් කල් ලංකාවේ පැවැත්වුණු හැම තරගාවලියක්ම අපි වර්ල්ඩ් කප් ක්වොලිෆයර්ස් තිබුණත් වර්ල්ඩ් කප් ක්වොලිෆයර්ස් ලංකාවේ තියෙනකොට ඒක ආසියානු පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයෙන් තමයි ඒක ඕගනයිස් කරන්නේ. FIFA එකේ තරගාවලියක් වුණා. මේක FIFA එකේ තරගාවලියක්. ඒතර මේක FIFA එකෙන්ම තමයි ඕගනයිස් වෙන්නේ. ඒතර ඒ මට්ටමට හැම දෙයක්ම තියෙන්න ඕනේ. ඒක ලේසි පහසු දෙයක් නෙමෙයි ඒක කරන්න. ඒක තමයි අපිට මේකේ වෙනදට වඩා යම්කිසි වෙනසක් තේරෙන්න. මම හිතන්නේ ඒක අපිට ලැබුණ ලොකු වාසනාවක් මේක පවත්වන්න. මේ වගේ අභියෝග අපි ජය ගන්න ඕනේ. මේ වගේ අභියෝග අප අර ගන්න ඕනේ. මේ අවස්ථාවේදී ලංකාවට මේ වගේ දෙයක් අවශ්‍යයි. දැන් මේ අපිට දකිනවා මේ මාසෙ තුල 850,000 විතර මේ අවුරුද්ද තුල ලංකාවට පැමිණලා තියෙනවා විදේශිකයෝ. මං හිතන්නේ මේ වගේ දේවල් තියෙන තවත් කට්ටිය ලංකාවට එන්න බලනවා. ඉතින් ඒකින් ද මං හිතන්නේ මේ අභියෝගය අපි ගත්ත අභියෝගය හොඳයි. ඉදිරියටත් මේ වගේ තරගාවලිය ඇතුවේ කියලා මම බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා.
ඒ වගේම මම දැනගන්න කැමති ඔතුමන්ගෙන් දැන් මේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාව සහ පැපුවා නිව ගිනියාව කණ්ඩායම අද දිනේදී ක්‍රීඩා කරන. ඒ වගේම ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායම එළබෙන සඳුදා දිනේදී සුදන වෙලා ඉන්නවා බූතාන කණ්ඩායමත් එක්ක ක්‍රීඩා කරන. දැන් අද දිනේදී බූතාන කණ්ඩායමට ගෝල ලබා ගන්න හැකියාවක් ලැබුණේ නැහැ. ගෝල 6ට 0ක් විතර තරගයේ ජයග්‍රහණය කරන්න මධ්‍යම අප්‍රිකාවට හැකියාවක් ලැබුණා. බූතාන කණ්ඩායමත් එක්ක අපි එළබෙන සඳුදා දිනේදී තරගවදීන සුදන වෙලා ඉන්නවා. ඉතින් මේ තරගයේදී මොන වගේ අභියෝගයක් ලැබෙවිද අපි දැක්කාද ඕන ක්‍රීඩා කරන විලාසය?
මං හිතන්නේ බූතානේ අපිට ලොකු අභියෝගයක් දෙයි. මොකද ගිය තරග දෙකේම අපි බූතානයත් එක්ක බූතානයත් එක්ක ක්‍රීඩා කරපු ගිය තරග දෙකේම අපි පරාජය වුණා. අපි එතෙක්කල් බූතානයට කිසිම තරගයක පැරදිලා නැහැ. හැබැයි අන්තිමට ක්‍රීඩා කරපු දෙකේ පැරදුණා. ඉතින් මං හිතන්නේ ඒගොල්ලන් අභියෝගයක් දෙයි. හැබැයි මම හිතනවා අපේ සංජිතයේ ඉන්න තැන 90 අපිට ඒක ජයග්‍රහණය කරන්න පුළුවන් වෙයි කියලා.
එවගේ මම දැනගන්න කැමති උපසභාපතිතුමනි, දැන් මම හිතන්නේ මේක මේ එකපාර්ට් මේ වගේ තරගාවලියක් සංවිධානය කරන්න බෑ. මම හිතන්නේ ලොකු ඕගනයිසේෂන් එකක්. ඒ වගේම අපි කතා කරලා තියෙන ඉදිරි වසර ගණනාවේදීම මේ ඔබතුමන්ගේ නව සභාපතිත්වයේ යටතේ ඔබතුමන්ලාගේ මේ සභාපතිත්වයේ යටතේ මම හිතන්නේ මේ ඉදිරි වසර ගණනාව පුරාවටම තරගාවලිය ගණනාවක් සංවිධානය කරලා තියෙනවා. මම හිතන්නේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ පාපොන්න ගොඩනගා ගන්න අපි කලින් කතා කරපු විදිහට මම හිතන්නේ සභාපතිතුමන් කිව්ව විදිහටම තරගාවලිය ගණනාවක් සංවිධානය කරලා තියෙනවා. මම දැනගන්න කැමති මේ සභාපතිතුමත් එක්ක වැඩ කරගෙන යන ඉදිරියට තරගාවලිය ගණනාවක්
ඒකට ලොකු මුදල් ප්‍රමාණයක් වැය කරන්නත් අපි ඉහ වෙලා ඉන්නවා. හැබැයි මම මතක් කරන්න ඕනේ අපි අපේ ප්‍රේක්ෂකයන්ට අපේ ලංකාවේ කණ්ඩායමත් එක්ක එක්ව වෙන්න අපේ ක්‍රීඩකයන්ට ඇවිල්ලා ඔබලාගේ ආදරේ පෙන්වන්න ඒගොල්ලන්ගේ දිරිමත් කරන්න උඩට ගන්න. මොකද මේ අවුරුද්ද පුරා ලබන අවුරුද්දේ සාෆ්ට් ගේම්ස් එක අපි සාෆ්ට් ටෝර්නමන්ට් එක ලංකාවේ පවත්වන්න බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන්නේ. එතකන් අපි තියෙන හැම FIFA වින්ඩෝ එකකම ලංකාව තරඟ කරන්න අපි බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා. ඒකේ දෙකක් පිටරට ගිහිල්ලත් අනිත් දෙක ලංකාවෙත් අපි පවත්වන්න බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා. ඉතින් මං හිතන්නේ මේ අවුරුද්ද පුරාම ජූනි මාසයේ, සැප්තැම්බර් මාසයේ, නොවැම්බර් මාසයේ, ලබන අවුරුද්දේ මාර්තු මාසයේ ආයි ජූනි මාසේ වෙනකන් අපේ ජාතික කණ්ඩායමට අපි තරඟ තීරණය කරලා ඉවරයි. ඒතර ඒකින්ද ඇවිල්ලා අපේ ලංකාවට සපෝට් කරන්න කියලා මම ඉල්ලනවා.
ඒ වගේ මම මතක් කරන්න ඔබතුමන්න දැන් මම දන්නේ එළබෙන වසර ටිකක් තීරණාත්මක වසරක් අපේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාවට. මොකද 1985 වසරේදී අපි අවසන් වරට ආසියානු ශූරයන් බවට පත් වෙනවා. හරියටම වසර ගණනාවකට පස්සේ තමයි එළබෙන වසර එළබෙන්නේ. ඉතින් මේ වගේම තරගාවලියක් පවත්වන්න සූදානම් වෙලා තියෙනවා. මම හිතන්නේ ශ්‍රී ලංකා කණ්ඩායම අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම මේ තරගාවලිය දිහාවට තමයි ඊළඟට මාන බලාගෙන ඉන්නේ, ජයග්‍රහණය කරන්නේ. මොකද මම හිතන්නේ වාර්තාවක් අපිට දෙන්න හැකියාවක් නැහැ. මොකද වසර ගණනාවකින් අපිට ශූරතාවයක් ලබා ගන්න හැකියාවක් ලැබුණේ නැහැ. ඉතින් එළබෙන වසර තීරණාත්මකයි. අපිට හොඳ කණ්ඩායමක් ඉන්නවා මේ වෙද්දී. එළබෙන වසරේදී මම දැනගන්න කැමතියි මේ එළබෙන ආසියානු තරගාවලියේ ජයග්‍රහණය කරන්න මොන වගේ ප්ලෑන් එකක්ද, මොන වගේ සැකස්මක්ද තියෙන ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ?
මම හිතන්නේ අපි දැන් කිව්වා වගේ අපි හැම තරග වාරයකම ක්‍රීඩා කරන්න බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා. අපේ ජාතික සංචිතය අපි දිගටම පවත්වා ගන්න යන්න තීරණය කළා තියෙනවා. අපි මැයි මාසෙ වෙනකොට අපි ලංකාවේ ක්ලබ් වල තරග පටන් ගන්නවා. ඒතර ඒ ළමයින්ට ඒකෙත් අත්දැකීම් ලැබෙනවා. මට මතකයි අවුරුදු 30කට ඉස්සෙල්ලා සුගතදාස ක්‍රීඩාංගණයේ ඉන්දියාවේ එකයි බිඳුවකට පරද්දනකොට ඒ ක්‍රීඩාංගණයේ තිබුණ විද්‍යා 20,000ක් පමණ ලෝලීන් ඇවිල්ලා ලංකාවේ පොඩි කළා. මගේ ඇස්වල සතුටු කඳුළු තිබුණා එදා. මම බලාපොරොත්තු වෙනවා තව අවුරුද්දකින් ජූනිම ලබන අවුරුදු ජූනි මාසෙත් ඒ විදියට මේක සමරන්න.
මම හිතන්නේ අපි වැදගත් කතා බහක් එක තමයි එකතු වුණේ. මේ තමයි බොහෝ විට ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ පාපන්දු වසන්තයේ විය හැක්කේ එළබෙන තරගයේ ශ්‍රී ලංකාව සහ පැපුවා නිව ගිනියාව අතර තවත් සුළු මොහොතකින් ආරම්භ වෙන සූදානම් වෙලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් බෙහෙවින් ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙනවා ශ්‍රී ලංකා පාපන්දු සම්මේලනයේ උපසභාපති වෛද්‍ය මනිල මනෑට මහතාට මේ කතා බහත් එක්ක එකතු වුණාට. අපි සූදානම් තරගයේ සජීව තොරතුරුත් එක්ක මෙතෙන් සිට එකතු වෙන්න.
Thank you.
A very good evening, a grand evening to all of our viewers joining us through SBC TV and Sri Lanka Sports. SBC TV and Sri Lanka Football TV. And through the live, Facebook handle of Sri Lanka Football as well. A warm welcome to all of you. FIFA Series 2024, Sri Lankan edition. The second game of the day, Sri Lanka taking on Papua New Guinea. In a packed crowd in the Racecourse International Stadium, Sri Lanka football in a new look, in a fresh beginning, taking on Papua New Guinea today. The first international assignment for Sri Lanka in the year of 2024. We are We had a bit of showers, a heavy rain shower, an hour or two ago, and now the ground is ready, the crowd is ready, and the players are of course ready for some solid football action for the next 90 minutes. As you see in the pictures, the football fraternity of Sri Lanka have turned up in numbers. You see the dressing room of Sri Lanka. Some legendary names who have represented Sri Lanka for so long. You see the players walking in. What a day it is going to be representing your country at the highest level is indeed what all the players are rooting for, to represent your country at the highest level.
We haven't seen this over, like I say, the last month, but yeah, we're ready. We're as ready as we'll, as we possibly can be.
Thank you, Andy. All the best.
Look, I think it's probably going to be a different type of game now. We're obviously hoping to play an open, expansive game on the pitch. We trained here last night; it was excellent. So, I'm assuming now the conditions might be a bit more different out there, and we're going to need to adapt. And I'm sure they will as well. So, look, we'll see how we go. We obviously hope for a big crowd tonight and a really good spectacle for Sri Lankan football, and we want to play our part in that.
Okay, thank you, Warren, and all the best.
As you see on the pictures, Papua New Guinea team walking in. What a moment it's going to be for the players from both the countries as they are already in the tunnel to walk in to the team introduction. There you go, Team Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea walking in for the lineup of FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lankan edition, second game of the day. Sri Lanka currently ranked 204, taking on Papua New Guinea at the currently rank of 165. Sri Lanka team led by iconic Sujan Pereira.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
We are ready for the national anthems of both the teams. all set for the national anthem of Sri Lanka. I welcome my co-commentator for the day, Kavika. Welcome back.
Hello, Akhil, and a good evening to everyone listening in here at the racecourse grounds. We welcome you to the match of the FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lanka edition. As we see, the Sri Lankan team, Sujan Pereira, comes back to captain the squad. Harsha Fernando at right back. Dylan De Silva, star player, of course, wearing the number 10. Jude Supan, hailing from Jaffna. Claudio Kamenecht, one of the greatest additions. Wasim Razik, who has experience playing up front. Jason Thayaparan, of course, an important name. Jack Hingert, we'll be hearing more about him later. Steven at number 6. And we have Pereira and Ardavan to complete the lineup. As for the substitutes, we see Chalino Chamira, Asiku Rauman, Kavisha Fernando, Shinal Sandesh, and we'll see much more of the Sri Lankan team on as they gear up for some team photos. The crowd is starting to fill in quite nicely here as we take a look at the toss. The referee for this game is Meshari Ali Mari from Qatar. His two assistant referees, Khaled Ai from Qatar as well. And from Qatar as well, we have Faisal Eid Al-Shamari. And as the fourth official, we'll have Kasun Lakmal Veerakodi from Sri Lanka.
The team card for Papua New Guinea: Ronald Wilson, Godfrey Haru, Emmanuel Simon, Troy Dobin, Yagi Yasasa, Jesse Greece, Kolu Kepo, Philip Steven, Daniel Joe, Kenneth Ara, and Lee Naufont. The head coach for Papua New Guinean setup is Warren Moon from Australia. Papua New Guinea is ranked 165th in FIFA rankings. And you see the substitutes of Papua New Guinean squad as well.
Well, it's almost a full house here at the racecourse grounds. There was some rain, well, you might see a bit of damp ground as well. It was inspected by both teams and both teams saw that it was happy, but I feel like there would be, or rather, it is a test of time. As long as the pitch holds up, we are in for a cracking game, because bear in mind that Sri Lanka are back. This is a renaissance period for Sri Lanka, Akhil. And Papua New Guinea are trying to make a statement here, as should say, in the lower ranked region of world football, not to mention Sri Lanka too, is 204th out of 210 nations. So looking to bounce back into the top 200 as We get things underway. Dylan De Silva sends it back to Sujan Pereira, who made his comeback appearance after resigning from captaincy late last year because of what had happened. So Sri Lanka had undergone a bit of rough change after what we saw. It got a bit ugly, to be honest, because it's not what Sri Lankan fans would have wanted. There's an immediate corner kick, much the delight of the Sri Lankan fans. Sri Lanka in white and Papua New Guinea in red. Like I said, Akhil, there is a renaissance period that Sri Lanka are undergoing with a lot of scouting done from the Sri Lankan Federation. They're looking to target people, or rather players, with Sri Lankan roots. And that's going to be very interesting to see how they come up with that sort of strategy in the future, because it's an ingenious plan, I should say. I should say it's a genius plan. But will it work in Sri Lanka's favor? I think this is the time that we should maybe sit back and observe as Adhavan floats one in. And there is an attempt, but it goes over the bar. Good start for Sri Lanka, Akhil.
Superb start for Sri Lanka there. Adhavan Rajmohan was instrumental for Sri Lanka in the FIFA World Cup qualifier games versus Yemen. In both the legs, we saw Adhavan was very engaged with free kicks and corner kicks. Very good start for Sri Lanka to start the proceedings. Once again, Adhavan Rajmohan. Harsha Fernando. And Wasim Razik with an opportunity there, unfortunately.
Yeah, as I said, Akhil, the ground is going to play a massive part in this, because just not too long ago, one could say that we would have not played the match because of what we were seeing, because there were flood, or rather water hose here and there in the pitch, especially in the middle part of the pitch, as you can see.
Harsha takes the throw in for Sri Lanka. Harsha usually takes the throw in for Sri Lanka for the last 2-3 years. What a player he has been. Currently moved on to upcountry Lions. Sri Lanka with the correct intent shown in the first 2-3 minutes.
Yeah, of course, something what Coach Andy Morrison mentioned yesterday at the press conference was that Sri Lanka are gunning to go at this. This is a good opportunity to test out what he has in his lab, because right now the lab is full of interesting prospects. We can see Sri Lanka use their experiments really well. Coach Andy Morrison, of course, came about a month ago into the Sri Lankan mix-up. He has experience, a former Manchester City title-winning captain, with him winning the second division of the English League. So rather, we'd call it the Championship. But he does have very strong ties to the English game, and he was described by the English media and also the England fans as a bit of a tank at the back, being a defender. So he was a centre half, and no stranger to scoring goals as well. He was a good goal scorer, and something that Wasim Razik is trying to do as well. Goals score. Papua New Guinea get it out of the danger area. Here's Adhavan trying to chip one in. Fortunately, not for. Here's Dylan De Silva trying to work his magic through. It's a good cross, but there's no one on the end of it. Here's Jason. Jason, also one of the prospects from the German, the fifth tier. J- Jason coming in from SV Eintracht.
As you see on the screen, earlier, we were talking about the coaching staff of Sri Lanka, also assisted by Mohammad Amanullah, who was a Golden Boot winner, where Sri Lanka had the last glory in football, the 1995 SAF Golden Cup. That was the last glory time Sri Lanka had in football. And with the current vision of the current Football Federation is to repeat the glory in exactly 20 years next year.
Were you there in 95? Were you there in 95?
I was just 2 years.
2 years. At least it beats me. I wasn't even born. So it's been that long, I should say. It's been that long since Sri Lanka has seen some sort of glory. And pretty sure that this might be the next generation. Who knows? Papua New Guinea feeling the heat. And talking about heat, should I say that it has been a couple of very humid weeks in Sri Lanka. It's just only last night that it started to rain after quite some time in Sri Lanka. So the question was asked by a lot of journalists yesterday at the press conference. The first question was probably, how are you going to face this sort of climate, Akhil? And all the coaches and players, or rather captains, they mentioned that they do have experience. For example, Bhutan was playing in India, so not too dissimilar to what Sri Lanka is facing right now, because India's same climate, should say. Papua New Guinea also off that tropical climate, so they are coming in as sort of, well, they know how to play their game, especially in heat like this. First 7 minutes up, and the crowd seems to be with Sri Lanka. Of course, it's home advantage. As you can hear, the Papari bands in the background. For all those unfamiliar, Papari band is a supporting group. Consists of a trumpet, drum. I hope I'm not shaming the Papari bands when I try to guess what trumpets or other. Well, there's an attempt, and it just floats over the bar. So, two attempts, but both of them have gone over the bar. It's just the direction they need to work on, because they are winning these duels in the air. Something that maybe about 4 or 5 years ago you would have questioned, like, wow. But right now, Sri Lanka has gotten hold of very physical players. As we mentioned earlier, we have two centre-backs who are playing in German leagues. That's Jason, who's playing for SV Eintracht in the fifth tier of the German divisions. And Claudio, who is in the third tier of the German division. He plays for SG Dynamo.
Exactly, Kavinka. That is one factor where about when we watch football for the last 4 or 5 years, certain football fans will ask, when will we be able to compete in the international level? So today is pretty evident that Sri Lanka is making some good strides, some attacking football for the first 9 minutes of the game so far.
And just to educate our viewers, some team facts. This is Sri Lanka's first match against an Oceania team. And Sri Lanka's record in their previous 6 matches against non-Asian Federation teams is 1 win, 1 draw, and 4 losses. So they'll certainly be looking to make that a bit of a good sight. 4 of the matches were against Seychelles. 1 win, 1 draw, and 2 losses. Their other two opponents were German DR and Sudan, whom they lost to both on both occasions. Sri Lanka's only previous win against a non-AFC team was a 2-1 away win against Seychelles in August of 2014. So that's almost 10 years ago. Sri Lanka aiming for their first victory since they defeated Bangladesh 2-1 in Colombo in November 2021 at the 2021 Four Nations Football Tournament. A lot of these players weren't there, Akhil. But let's talk a bit about Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea's record in their previous 13 matches against Oceania, or rather non-Oceania teams, is 4 wins, 2 draws, and 7 losses. Must be noted that they have not faced Australia since Australia actually moved to the Asian Federation. So Australia is not part of the Oceania Federation. Did you know that?
Interesting facts. Thank you, Kavinka, for enlightening us with some interesting facts.
Well, there's one more. That's Papua New Guinea's last victory against a non-Oceania team was at home against Malaysia in June 2016. So both teams are looking to prove something. It's just a matter of being a bit more graceful on the pitch.
Exactly. It has been a happy hunting ground for Sri Lanka. As you said, the last victory for Sri Lanka came in 2021 versus Bangladesh in the Four Nations Tournament, where that game was the decider, where the finalists will be selected based on the winner of that particular game. And score was 1-1, and at the 90th minute of that game, Wasim Razik won a penalty. So with that, Sri Lanka sealed that game. So that was the last victory for Sri Lanka in international level, and Sri Lanka lost the finals to Seychelles once again in a penalty shootout. There are a few players who represented Sri Lanka at that particular game who are playing today as well, named the captain Sujan Pereira, Wasim Razik, and Dylan De Silva played that tournament. Unfortunately, he injured and he didn't play that particular game versus Bangladesh. So those are good happy memories for Sri Lanka during the Four Nations tournament.
Yeah, an interesting fact is that Coach Warren of Papua New Guinea, he said that Jack Hingert, the Sri Lankan left back, has made over 250 appearances for Brisbane Roar. And guess who was the coach for about 250, or rather 200 games of those? It was Coach Warren of Papua New Guinea. So timelines do align, should say. That's a very interesting fact. So for sure, Coach Warren would have advised his contingent on the threat of Jack Hingert.
Junior boys are assisting with the ball for the seniors. This is a good sign to see.
An interesting fact, actually. Did you know that in England, in the English divisions, you're not allowed to do that? Rather, you can't have towels on the sidelines. You can't have towels on the sidelines to clean those balls because of certain methods of making things unfavorable.
There's some fact for you. Thank you on those.
Every day is a school day. Here's a long throw. Harsha Fernando almost joining us in the commentary box over here. Let's see what Harsha Fernando can do.
Harsha is typically known for those long throws, has been successful many times for the clubs he has played and also Sri Lanka.
That was a good attempt, but Ronald, the captain of Papua New Guinea, wasn't too worried there. Cross in by Harsha Fernando. Yes, that was Stephen, who got his head to the ball. Well, of course, the first 15 minutes haven't been too kind to Papua New Guinea, but it's a game of football. 90 minutes, anything can happen. We saw that in the previous match that was the Central African Republic versus Bhutan, where the former just plowed their way through in that second half. We saw two goals in 2 minutes, courtesy of their forward line, in very quick succession. So it's a game of football, anything can happen. Sri Lankans, even though they are in front, must note that the pace of Yassas and Grese are not to be tampered with.
Talking about rhythm, it was just a matter of time where Central African Republic players got into rhythm and it was their game.
Yes, because we mentioned in the first half that Bhutan may, or rather were, thinking of a comeback in that second half, but 2 minutes into the game, or rather 4 minutes into the game in the second half of that match, all signs of a comeback were erased, should I say.
As you see in the pictures, Wasim Razik representing Sri Lanka. He was the highest goal scorer in the South Asian region at the year of 2021. What an year he had for Sri Lanka, especially in one particular game where Sri Lanka was 4-0 down and Wasim Razik heroics ended up that game at 4-all. Wasim Razik scoring 4 goals in that game.
And there's a foul by Stephen. Foul was on Emmanuel Simon. Both of these nations have similar traits. But for starters, both nations, the most popular game, or rather one of the popular games, is rugby. And a question was posed yesterday to Coach Warren of Papua New Guinea, who is Australian himself and who does have experience watching rugby grow. The question was posed, how are you seeing football being popularized in such a climate? And he mentioned, Akhil, that it's just up to the players and up to the federation to do their own thing, not worry about other sports. It's a fairly smaller country as well. That's a nice ball there. And to Jack Hingert. Jack Hingert is finding him in an area which he's not too familiar with. He was listed as left back, but he's finding himself at right back.
Talking about PNG, they have made good strides in cricket as well, in top 20 in T20 rankings.
Definitely.
And one of their batsmen are in top 10. So good strides made in all sports. Good resilience shown by PNG.
Yeah, Papua New Guinea just need to keep a hold of the ball, really. Maybe the aerial threat might work. They could use that route once or twice, but the presence of Jason and Claudio prevent that. So they may have to try something else. This is reminiscent of the Bhutan versus Central African Republic game, where Bhutan was just out-muscled by that Central African Republic team. So they tried taking the aerial route, and once or twice you could see them look for ground passes, which I feel Papua New Guinea could do. You think that maybe ground passes are much better suited towards, or rather against, the aerial route?
Ground passes should suit according to the conditions today.
Well, you're talking about the pitch.
Yeah,
maybe the pitch might play
yes,
a factor in
major
that.
Role as well. So advice was given to Bhutan players from the comment box to stick to ground passes. Unfortunately, they couldn't follow it in the previous game.
But Sri Lanka is playing a very high line, maybe the instructions of coach Andy Morrison, as Jack Hingert gets that out.
You think the Sri Lankan outfit should take a bit of time to settle as a gel, to gel as a team?
Well, that question was also posed yesterday to coach Andy Morrison, and he said that proceedings have been good. That's all he had to say, but he did elaborate on the fact that they are together, and Sri Lanka has been through so many things, including an economic crisis. So all things considered, he has worked really well in the past month to bring all these players, including the players who have experience in foreign leagues, and try to gel them together. But the tides are switching, because Yasasa has his eyes over the ball. Let's see what Yasasa can do. Goes directly into the wall and cleared out by Wasim Razik. Now to Danjo. It's not too often that you see a center back with the number 10 t-shirt, Kepo. But it's quite often that you see maybe their best player playing and donning the number 10 t-shirt. You see a replay of that. It was actually Jude Supan. He's the one that blocked that threat, but it was going safely into the hands of Sujan Pereira.
Jude Supan is another young player, he's hailing from a different part of the country, Jaffna. Football is a sport that which covers most part of the country, being represented Sri Lanka as well.
Here's Dylan
De Silva with an opportunity. Cleanly collected there by Ronald Warshan, the captain of Papua New Guinea.
Yeah, probably the most dangerous moment for Sri Lanka in the opening 22 minutes. Fair to say that Papua New Guinea has only had one chance. Right on screen is Dylan De Silva, plays his football in the UK for Willstone. Is a former Tottenham Hotspurs QPR youth player as well. He's played for Dockery too. And recently in the winter transfer window, did he move to Willstone. Recently scored a goal and would be really happy to be in the Sri Lankan squad.
Kick taken by Dylan De Silva there, collected in a cool and calm manner by Ronald Warshan, the captain.
Yeah, Dylan just 21 years of age and belongs to a set of youngsters here in the Sri Lankan outfit. Papua New Guinea get it out of danger's way. One thing that has impressed me is the fact that they are very calm under pressure. Sri Lanka is doing their bit to try and stall that pressure, or rather disturb that pressure, and or rather that calmness. But as you saw there, Font was there to put the ball out. So there is something calming about seeing the passing of Papua New Guinea.
As we are witnessing the second game of the day of FIFA Series 2024, Sri Lankan edition. Papua New Guinea taking on the host, Sri Lanka.
There you have on screen Jack Hingert, one of the recruitments, would you say? He does have Sri Lankan roots, even though he plays his football in Australia. Here's Wasim Rasik trying to ping one in. It's a mistake by the Papua New Guinea defense. And here's a chance to counter-attack. Papua New Guinea with two players in front. Doesn't make the most of it there. And Sri Lanka go again with Jason on the ball, instructing his players to launch it forward. And that's exactly what he does. Into the path of Philip. Here's Emmanuel Simon threading it through to Danjo.
The defense of Papua New Guinea has been good so far in this game. They have been very calm and not succumb to any pressure.
That's the head coach, Warren Moon from Australia. He did make a point that Papua New Guinea is ready for the challenge. It's a good headed ball to Dylan De Silva. Wasim Rasik trying to twist and turn, gets his shot, but not quite what he would have hoped for. Here's Font on the ball. Well, that's the fifth or sixth time that Papua New Guinea have tried that aerial route, but it has not worked out for them. Maybe like we said, like we debated in the past, or rather 10 minutes ago, we were talking about how they can maybe thread the ball through on the ground, but it is a choice of theirs to go with the aerial route.
Yes.
As Sujan Pereira launches the ball into Moon, Warren Moon.
Sujan has been representing Sri Lanka at the highest level for almost a decade now. What a player he has been for Sri Lanka. He's actively engaged in club football in Maldives. Also known as the Superman of South Asia.
Jason trying to playing it through to Dylan De Silva, gets fouled.
What do you think, Kamika? The origin players will have a bit of time settling in playing under this condition, which I'm sure they have not played much under these type of conditions.
Yeah, that's right, and the ball is launched. It's a bit of a miscommunication there, but Ronald gets it into his hands and starts an attack for Papua New Guinea. Well, you could say as long as it stays like this and Papua New Guinea absorb the pressure, as we see there, Jason rolling it into Dylan De Silva, but it's fouled there by Godfrey Haro. I think physicality would have been emphasized at each of Andy Morrison's training sessions, because it's something that is required in the modern game. It has always been required, but it has a special place, physicality. We're just over 30 minutes here played at the Racecourse International in Sri Lanka. You're watching the FIFA Series 2024, the Sri Lankan edition. You're watching the second match, Sri Lanka versus Papua New Guinea. Neither team has scored, but Sri Lanka has had the upper hand in the opening half hour. Papua New Guinea a bit happy to sit back and absorb that pressure. It's also most of the Sri Lankan players' debuts as well. For those wondering, most of the players did come from the Aspire project. The Aspire project was a Sri Lankan football project which was in Qatar. And Sri Lanka did find some players from that. Sources close to the commentary team say that Warren and Dylan, except for those two, everyone else in the starting lineup, and of course except Dylan and Sujan Pereira, the others were found from the Aspire project, is it?
There are a few players who are part of the Aspire project, and Sri Lanka had a training camp in Aspire Academy in Qatar a few months ago, and Sri Lanka played some friendlies with the clubs in Qatar as well, which gave a lot of positive results. See the bench strength as well. Sri Lanka has a good bench strength. Also, Fernando taking the throw in for Sri Lanka.
Yeah, talking about the bench, they have Akib, number 7, who represents Colombo FC, 21 years of age. Also, Suresh at 19 years old, Suresh Rahul, who also has international experience. Jack Hingert getting into the thick of things. Can use both feet, something that is a gift in modern times if you can use both feet. Jack Hingert, a possessor of that gift. You've seen him cross with his right foot, but now it's time for his left foot to do some magic. Jack Hingert leaves it to Arthurman. When it's a collision there between Ronald and one of the Sri Lankan players. Doesn't look too good. Ronald seems to be holding his knee. Take a look at the replay. That was the first attempt for Sri Lanka in the opening few minutes. Andy Morrison just instructing his players what to do. It's been a bright start, but Sri Lanka would want to make more of the pressure that they are pushing towards the Papua New Guinea outfit.
See the magic spray coming out. How many times you have seen the magic spray coming out and saving the players?
Absolutely, and a lot of technological and health advancements. We see here Andrew Morrison. As I said, former Manchester City captain and a league winner as well, won the second division with Manchester City. There we see a collision between Warren and I believe that was Jason.
As the injured players are being treated, there's a small water break taken. you see on the crowd, the crowd is race course is filled, almost filled for this international friendly between Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea.
A lot of talk on social media is that Sri Lanka football might be looking into dealing with much more players who play in foreign leagues, but what about the local leagues? Of course, each and every Sri Lankan fan might look to say that local players also deserve a chance, those who play locally. But this was questioned to, rather asked to, asked by the journalists to Andy Morrison, and he said that results matter, and that's what he's looking at.
That was one burning question yesterday during the press conference as well.
Definitely.
The players, the origin players, playing with the Sri Lankan players, Sri Lankan based players, it's a good mixture to have and a good competition as well, so that the players from the domestic leagues and the school system will start being more competitive. So that's a, those are good signs for Sri Lanka football moving on. So we'll hope there will be some healthy competitions which will benefit the country's football eventually.
Absolutely. Here we see on the other flank, Harsha Fernando taking his place. Launches one in. Nicely dealt with there by Papua New Guinea players, but comes into Yasasa. Well, that's a good turn by Dylan De Silva. He was looking for the curler there. You could see what he was trying to do, turning away from his defender. Talented boy there playing for Wellstone. He knows what he's capable of. The coach knows what he's capable of. Sri Lankan fans know what he's capable of as well. Just look at that nice piece of skill there. Just unlucky with his left foot. Here's Kepo on the ball trying to calm things down. But for Papua New Guinea, it looks like it's a matter of getting it into their forward line, because they're the forward line consisting of Yassas and Grese. As we see there, a foul by Danjo. As I was saying, Yassas and Grese have not had the service they would have liked. Claudio Kamenecht, one of the additions into the Sri Lankan outfit, looks to be down injured. Not sure why though. Must be holding his groin. Sujan Pereira, the captain, asking if he requires a substitution. Could be a big blow, because Jason and Claudio, two defenders from the German leagues, trying to establish their presence and dominance, and they've done so well against Yasasa and Grese. We see the crowd here. There's only a few seats left. If you're in and around Colombo in this area, we're inviting you to come and watch the FIFA Series 2024, the Sri Lankan edition. Fans of all ages here present. Yeah, it seems to be a groin injury. That's a big blow for Sri Lanka.
There you go. The second attempt by Dylan De Silva there. A valiant attempt indeed by Dylan.
Ronald very furious with his defenders over there.
Your captain and your coaches are never happy whatever you do, right?
Absolutely. They deserve, they, or rather they want the best from the side. been 40 minutes. The 5 more minutes to go until half time. And the score still stands all level. Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea both at nil all. Well, one thing to note is that these players in the Sri Lankan outfits, even though you might see most of those players living in foreign countries, they have Sri Lankan roots, and that's what matters. You can see a lot of that happening. Well, one main or prime example would be Ashraf Hakimi, who was eligible to play for Spain, but he chose his allegiance towards Morocco, and fair to say he did well. There's good play there by Harsha Fernando, reading his attacker quite well and drawing in the foul. Fair to say that Gresse was on his own there, and that's what's missing. The fact that Gresse and Yasasa don't have enough supply, and when they do get the ball, they don't have enough players to support. So that's something to fix for coach Warren Moon during halftime. He's a bit out of picture, but we can see him ask his coaching staff what exactly he should do. Just a reminder that Claudio Kramenecht was on the floor a few minutes ago, and now he's back on it again. So it looks like a substitution will have to be made. Looks like a groin injury. So as I was saying, most of these players do have Sri Lankan roots, and it's not a stranger to Sri Lanka, but also it's not a stranger to the international game as well.
What do you think Sri Lanka should do in the second half? Should they strengthen up their attack a bit more?
Well, in terms of defense and the midfield, they look quite strong. Their physical presence there as well. It's just that the attackers, Wasim Razik and Dylan De Silva, as we see here, substitution being made. Claudio Kramenecht coming off. Coming in for Claudio is Chamira, number four. So Sri Lanka have a new partnership. As we see there, Wasim Razik getting offside. So Sri Lanka have a new makeshift partnership at the back. See Jason. It looks to be a back two. I don't think Sri Lanka have settled in too well. They're still asking Coach Andy what they should be lining up with. So it looks like Chamira has slotted into that right back position. Ball is hoofed away. It seems to be a back five now. So Harsha Fernando at left back. It's Jason at the center back position, as we have a confirmation of Kramenecht coming off for Chalana Chamira.
Additional time, 4 minutes.
A total of 4 minutes will be added. 4 minutes for Sri Lanka to find a way into making something from this. Here's Jack Hingert. Jude Supan, who has slotted into that centre-back role. So the defensive midfielder playing a role as centre-back, we've not seen too many times of that happening. Shamira unable to keep the ball in play. So in the second half, Akhil, it looks like Sri Lanka can do the same of what they did. It's just that Wasim Razik and Dylan De Silva have to take their chances as well. And also, Sri Lanka should not be too afraid to try out some long-distance shots.
Exactly. The first half has relatively good, have been good for Sri Lanka so far. It's only they will have to only increase the pace a bit in the second half, have some shots at target, which will add pressure on the Papua New Guinean defense. Talking about PNG, they have been good in defense. They have been patiently waiting for opportunities. And Sri Lanka on the attack.
Dylan Silva trying to find one. And it goes into the hands of Ronald, who did fumble it at first. So Dylan De Silva has had the pick of the chances for Sri Lanka in this first half. First on the right wing, he twisted his defender and tried to get that curl, and similar circumstance in the second bit as well.
There you go. The third attempt by Dylan De Silva in the first half.
Here's Wasim Razik trying to, and he's brought down. The referee going into his pocket, and it is a yellow card for Papua New Guinea. The first yellow card. But fair to say, he was through on goal. Just awaiting confirmation on who received that yellow card. It was Danjo sliding in, trying to prevent that attack. And he did, but through
yellow
legal
card
means.
An opportunity to Sri Lanka to finish the first half in high.
Yeah, it's Adhavan over the ball here. This is Adhavan's third match. He did play versus Yemen. Sri Lanka did play Yemen and lost in the World Cup qualifiers. The leg was 3-0 and the second leg was 1-1. What can Adhavan do here? Adhavan for Sri Lanka, and it sails over the bar. And the referee calls for half-time. Scoreline still the same as it was in the tough beginning. All to play for in the second half. It is Sri Lanka 0, Papua New Guinea 0. Sri Lanka had the better chances of the two, but it was Papua New Guinea who was doing the defending, and quite good at the defending as well. Captain Ronald had to get in the thick of things. Would be demanding more from his attacking options as well. Dylan De Silva had two chances as well, Lakhil. So all to play for in the second half.
Yes, it has been a good 45 minutes of football so far. Where both the teams are
trying to get on, and Sri Lanka basically trying their best in attack. Unfortunately, couldn't finish any successful attempts there. Meanwhile, the PNG have been very good in defense. Interesting second half coming up as we wrap up the proceedings in the first half. We'll see on the pictures the highlights of the first half.
Yeah, that was Dylan De Silva. In fact, with three chances, that's the second one. And he had another one later on. Unfortunately, into the hands of Ronald. So, a packed house in Racecourse Grounds. Colombo is, or rather has experienced a rather dull first half in terms of scoreline, but all to play for in the second half. Don't go anywhere. You are watching the FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lanka edition. Match number two of match day one, Sri Lanka versus Guinea. It is 0-0.
Welcome to the second half action of FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lankan edition. The match between Papua New Guinea and the host Sri Lanka.
Player number 6, Sachandra Seaman, being replaced by player number 11, Chanel Sunday Stingo.
Steven goes out for Sri Lanka and Shenaz Sandesh making way. Shenaz Sandesh, another young football player hailing from St. Joseph's College, played his football for Blue Star SC Kalutara. Warmly welcome back, my co-commentator Kawinka. Welcome back.
Yeah, thank you, Akhil. So we just saw a change. Shenaz Sandesh coming into the thick of things. Fun fact, I've actually played against Shenaz Sandesh, and may I say that he's not a fun player to play against. He has his own bag of trickery as well. So I would say it's a smart substitution, considering the fact that Sri Lanka have not taken their chances, and coach Andy Morrison, it's a bold move, but fortune favors the bold. But in the opening minute, we see that Papua New Guinea has got things underway. Unlike how they started the first half, they are the ones who are trying to apply the pressure.
But a bit of wait and play was done by PNG in the first half. They have come with the intent of attacking in the second half.
Yeah, definitely, that would have been the instruction given out to Ronald's men. Papua New Guinea unchanged as they came out of the dugout. And just a small reminder that it was Sri Lanka's second substitution made there. There's Wasim Razik trying to get one in. Fortunately, that was not to be the case there.
Shenaz Sandesh missing out on a header there.
Yeah, if he was maybe about a head taller, he would have gotten to that, but fortunately, here is Dylan De Silva trying to wriggle his way through. Dylan De Silva gets past one, but eventually makes a foul, and it's PNG's ball. Coach Andy Morrison, or rather, sorry, it's Coach Warren Moon, having a word or two with the fourth official. And that's Jason, and despite losing his partner, Jason has done quite well to recoup. So Claudio Kamenek sustained an injury. Looked like it was a groin injury, and groin injuries aren't pretty, Akhil. So definitely we saw Chalana come in, Chalana Chamira, and he went into that right back position. We saw Jude Supan come into the center back role. So Jude Supan started as a center defensive midfielder, and now a center back.
Second half actions heating up a bit more than the first half.
Yep, definitely. Both sides know how to make their way into goal. Oh, and here's a chance for Sri Lanka, and Wasim Rasik heads the ball, but it was a few centimeters off goal. And just over 2 minutes into the second half, Wasim Rasik, a clear sight of goal after... That was Ronald's error. A clear and easy chance. Unfortunately for Wasim Rasik and the Sri Lankan fans over here, it wasn't to be.
What about that throw in there by Harsh Kawinkar?
Yeah, you mentioned that he specializes in those long throws and he's done it before. So I won't be surprised if he does it once or twice again. Feel like every time Sri Lanka has had a throw in, he's probably the first one to go and call saying, hey, I want it. Let me throw it. And I'll throw it. I'll even throw it into the goal. And that's almost what he did there. Here's Ardhavan. Ardhavan trying to thread it through to Dylan De Silva. Tries to find Wasim Rasik. His take two for Dylan De Silva. Tries to do some magic, and he does. And unfortunately doesn't seem to find the head of Wasim Rasik. You saw what he was trying to do. He was trying to curl that in. But Wasim Rasik, a bit more of that improvisation, and it would have resulted in breaking the deadlock. Good piece of skill to get past two players there. Yeah, unfortunately for Wasim Rasik and a few hundred Sri Lankan fans here at the Racecourse grounds in Colombo, it wasn't to be. So two chances in the space of 120 seconds. Exactly what coach Andy Morrison would like to see from his side.
Do you think there's a small delay in the ball getting onto that player? Maybe the soggy conditions having an effect on the passes.
Oh, and here's a chance for Papua New Guinea. Unfortunately, Yasasa couldn't control the ball too well with his head. Chalnan Chamira trying to do what he's been employed to do. And it's a corner for Papua New Guinea. Would you believe it? It's the first corner of the match for Papua New Guinea, Akhil. So just shows how Sri Lanka have been dominant. But things can change. Another 40 minutes to go here. As Yasasa is on the ball. Yasasa, let's see what he can do with this. It's a good ball through, and Sujan Pereira, like always, as always, has done over the years, claimed that ball as if it was his and his only. Although it has been about an hour and a half since it rained, it's fair to say that the ground is still trying to adapt, or rather the players are trying to adapt to the ground. Like you said, it's still soggy, so there's a tendency to have a slip or two here and there. Maybe the players can... Oh, that's wonderful skill by Dylan De Silva. He's been a gem to watch in this second half. It's Ardhavan, Jack Hingert, Chalnan Chamira. That's out by Philippe. Good pressure there applied by Troy Dobbin. But Sri Lanka get it out of harm's way. Jason all the way to Hingert. Hingert looking up, finds Chalnan Chamira. Dylan De Silva. Or rather, that was Senar Sandesh. And it's corner.
That was a collection by Sujan Pereira. As always, he has been doing for Sri Lanka. Collected in a cool and calm manner there. And Sri Lanka taking the corner.
Here's Wasim Razik. Unfortunately, was not on the same wavelength with Sena Sandesh. Beg your pardon, Chalan Chamira. And floated in, that's Claudio. Tries to get. Wasim Razik, of course, has experience playing in Germany, so there is a bit of German experience and German engineering in this squad as well, with Jason and also the injured Claudio coming in from the German leagues. Harsha Fernando will be looking to launch one of his famous throw-ins into the box. The last throw-in was almost a goal, so we'll be looking to do more of the same here. You could see the sweat on Harsha Fernando. It's just an indication of how hot and humid it still is. Goalkeeper Ronner comes out of his area, and it's another corner.
You see on the pitch as Vice President of Football Federation of Sri Lanka, Dr. Manuel Fernando, asking the cheering squad to be more vocal and support the home team.
Here's the other one, trying to find a head of a white t-shirt player. Hingert tries to keep the ball in play, which he does. Sena Sandesh out-muscled there by Emmanuel Simon. Just a note to all our viewers that the FIFA Series 2024 is, of course, an inaugural tournament. First of many, should I say, Akhil, because we also see a lot of other nations like even Egypt, New Zealand participating in their own version of the FIFA series as well. Lots of traveling for the players, and that's why we see, or rather we may not see, some important players. We rather didn't see Geoffrey Kondogbia of Olympique Marseille feature in that Central African Republic side, even though he is a veteran and is there captain. But the coach mentioned that although they do have friendlies, although national interest does arise, maybe here's a chance with Dylan De Silva. Well, how many times have we said his name, Dylan De Silva? Seems to be a bit of a tussle there. Warren with Wasim Razik. Well, it's a friendly by name, but not by nature, should I say, Akhil?
Exactly. Some ajbaj going on there, which will make the game more interesting as well.
Of course. Spoke to some fans and they said it was a dull, or rather boring, first half. Maybe their interests have been altered this time around. Here's the other one. Short corner, Harsha Fernando tries to loft one in, this time not with a throw-in. Zadavan once again, nicely controlled and hoofed away by the Papua New Guinea defense. Sujan Pereira coming back as captain, how has that been received by the Sri Lankan faithful, Akhil?
Exactly. Sujan is a very much a respected gentleman in Sri Lanka football fraternity. With the permanent captain, Charitha Ratnayaka, being injured during the training, it's the automatic choice that Sujan Pereira should take over the captaincy of Sri Lanka football. A senior member in the team. Talking about the FIFA series concept introduced by FIFA, which will eventually make the teams play more friendlies and improve their rankings as well, and also helps them to be exposed to competitive football from other continents as well. So it's all to gain for all four teams of this particular edition as well.
Here's Danjo coming in, tries to loft it across, and Sujan Pereira gets a hand to it. Danger's not cleared though, should have some work to do. There's a good passage of play there. These days, goalkeepers are required to do more than making saves. They're supposed to come out, be a sweeper keeper most of the times. We've seen that in the international stage with keepers like Manuel Neuer, Ter Stegen, Alisson, even Edison from Manchester City. Do those things, and Sri Lanka have one of their own. There's a substitution for Papua New Guinea. It's Kenneth coming off. And replacing him will be Rex Naim.
Compared to the first half, second half has been quite interesting, where both the teams have trying to attack. As you see, an injury being treated for Sujan Pereira.
Confirmation on that, it was Ati Kepo, although the board read number 16. He is the one that came on. As you can see, an Eintracht Trier banner. And I have a good guess that it is representing Jason. Jason of Eintracht, SV Eintracht. 28 years of age, is in the fifth tier of German football.
Adon Rajmohan in action for Sri Lanka, along with Jack Hingard there. quickly taken there by Sri Lanka.
Oh, and that's launched into the night sky by Kenneth. Beg your pardon, that was Philip.
Good to see a lot of young kids coming in to watch their country play.
Yep, definitely. People of all ages coming to watch Sri Lanka. It's around 10 local time in Sri Lanka right now.
Harsha Fernando with the throw in. Challenge Amira. Jude Supan. Dylan De Silva in a valiant effort to keep the ball in play.
No, they would not want to lose someone of the caliber of Dylan De Silva, as we see in the background there, coach Andy Morrison. Holding his head there, maybe in frustration. It's not something you'd want. Climate also playing a part.
Good to see a packed Race Course Stadium for an international football game after a long time.
Yep, something and something that they would want are goals. Unfortunately, Sri Lanka has come close to that, but not been successful in getting it. Just one moment is all it takes for even Papua New Guinea, who has been against the run of play, to come back and play. Papua New Guinea, of course, 165th in the world. Their highest rank was 159th, and here the ball stolen there by Papua New Guinea. And here's a chance. And that was a dangerous moment there. Danger has not subsided. Here come Papua New Guinea again. That was Kepo trying to find Emmanuel Simon. Here's Dylan De Silva. Seemed to have pushed one of the players. Thankfully, the referee did not see that. The player goes on. And it goes on with Papua New Guinea coming into it. Manuel Simon.
There was a good passage of play for Papua New Guinea there. They had about 2 to 3 chances.
Here's a good chance for Papua New Guinea. Here's Gressé, and there's a call there for a penalty, but the ref says no foul.
Jude Supan with defensive duties there. What's your call coming on that?
I would say that was a body tackle, of course, like a shoulder tackle, for sure. People forget that even though you see a lot of rolling and tumbling here and there in football and players going down very easily, it's also very easy to forget that football is a very physically demanding sport.
Correctly said, physically demanding sport is such a game such as football. And Sri Lanka once again on the attack.
Hingbert, Chalana, Hingbert again. Shanaz Sandesh. Papua New Guinea drawing a foul, and it's courtesy of Kepo using his experience there to draw in Shanaz Sandesh into tackling him and coming off successfully with the ball.
So we're entering the last 20 minutes.
Oh, and here's a chance for Sri Lanka. Ronald playing with fire there. Not what you'd want to do in your 6-yard area. Good skill by Dylan De Silva. Floats it in. Here's a chance for Chalana Chamira. Thankfully for a couple of deflections and the gloves of Ronald, doesn't make its way into the goal. Papua New Guinea breathing too. Big sigh of relief there.
Chalana Chamira with the shot at the goal there. So we're entering the last 20 minutes of the game as per our clock.
Warren Moon has been animated in this second half. We've seen him have a few words with the fourth official, and now he is also again on the touchline. He's just trying to bring out the best out of his players, and it's quite natural that a coach does remain animated. But in contrast, we've seen Andy Morrison remain a bit more calm and steady and talking to his technical team, his coaching staff, about how they can penetrate that Papua New Guinea defense as we gear up for another substitution.
Substitution for Papua New Guinea, player number 9, Michelle Dabinyaba, replacing player number 12, Jesse Greaves.
So it's Greaves coming off for Nigel Dabinyaba. So you have a solid number 9 playing up front. We're just confirming another substitution.
Substitution for Papua New Guinea, player number 18, Joseph Vaivai, replacing player number 3, Godfrey Harrow.
Godfrey Harrow coming off for Rex Naim.
Coach Warren Moon adding some fresh legs.
Yeah, correction, it was not Rex Naim who was coming off, it was YY. Reminder that there are a total of 6 substitutions, maximum of 6 substitutions each side can make. Even though this is a friendly match, sure to have substitutions. Non-friendly matches, of course, the limit was extended to 5 substitutions. That came right after the Qatar World Cup, where a lot of players were complaining of player fatigue, and rightly so. They changed it from 3 substitutions max to a total of 5. There was a handball call there, but it didn't look like it was a handball by Danjo. Was more of the face. He's asking the question, where was my hand, ref?
Referees are questioned frequently in a sport like football, especially today as well.
Well, and there's a mistake there by Sri Lanka. That was Jack Hingbert. Not someone you'd expect to make an error like that.
Sujan Pereira clears it and almost lands in the hockey turf right next to the race course.
Yeah, I was just mentioning that goalkeepers need to come up with much more than just saving and blocking shots. Kind of act like that 11th man. Confirmation of that change. Joseph YY coming on for Godfrey Harrow. Here's another chance. Sina Sandesh tries to float it in. Yeah, that was well dealt with by Philip.
One word to the defense of Papua New Guinea, who has been on alert. Whatever comes their way, they have been able to control.
Is Adhavan thinking of that quick corner, but instead opting to play a long ball into the box? Is Adhavan tries to look for Jack Hingbert. Chalana Chamira floats one in, but it almost goes to the goal behind that goal. If you were a Sri Lankan fan, would you say that what you've experienced thus far, considering the fact that considering the Yemen losses, both the Yemen losses, would you say that what you're seeing here is a bit better
actually
than what
second,
you saw?
Actually, the second Yemen game was a draw, where Sri Lanka finished up in one all, but aggregated points, Sri Lanka lost it. That Sri Lanka couldn't move on to the next stage in the World Cup qualifiers. But coming back into today's game, it's a mixed feeling for all the Sri Lankan fans. They could have had one or two goals under their belt. Still, this is how the game goes, right?
Definitely. Sri Lanka and winning has not come in the same sentence quite often in the past few years. They've experienced quite significant events, with them being banned from football due to administrative reasons. They've been hammered by South Korea. They lost their captain, Sujan Pereira, but now he's come back. They've stuck through it. But they have one task now, which is to delight a few hundreds in the stand by scoring a goal. So it can come in the form of Dylan De Silva, Wasim Razik, or even Sina Sandesh, or really anyone. Here's Wasim Razik, and there is... there's a yellow card produced to Papua New Guinea. The second yellow card for Papua New Guinea. Yeah, that was Joseph YY.
Yellow card for Papua New Guinea, player number 18, Joseph YY.
Papua New Guinea getting ready two substitutes this moment. Looks like it's Albert Simon and Karo Kila who are looking to come on.
As you said earlier, Sri Lanka football and the word W has been separated. So let's see over the next 10 to 12 minutes. Will that both the words will come together?
Yeah, this looks like a really good position for Adhavan to blast one in. But he just needs to focus on getting it into the right target. First over the wall and second under that bar, because there are around six players making up for that wall. Here's Adhavan.
Well, it's a good shot, and it's rebounded, and it's away from the Papua New Guinea goal. Dylan De Silva once again. Oh, they were so close, Akhil, to breaking the deadlock. 10 minutes before the full time was. Oh, it was actually Leon Pereira, I believe.
What a save it was in the first attempt by the captain of Papua New Guinea. I think Dylan De Silva was not ready there to finish it.
Oliver James Kellogg replacing player number 30, Wasim Razik. Wasim Razik coming off.
Player number 2, Manara Pereira replacing player number 3, Arthur Fernando.
Wasim Razik coming off for Oliver James Kellogg, forward number 9, and Harsha Fernando coming off for Manaram Pereira.
Substitution for Papua New Guinea, player number 5, Carol Pilar, replacing player number 50, Philip Stevens.
So another name that has been introduced is Oliver Kellogg. Oliver Kellogg, number 9 for Sri Lanka, plays in the second tier of Iceland in Njarðvík. So there's some more foreign experience for you.
Some fresh legs in the forward for Sri Lanka. Let's see what fortune it will bring for Sri Lanka as we're entering the 82nd minute of the game.
Yeah. Oh, and fair enough. I don't think that the Papua New Guinea or the Sri Lankan players were looking at that goal, at that ball. Oliver Kellogg reminds me of a certain Liverpool player, Akhil, Darwin Nunez.
Please carry on.
He'll be ready to maybe unlock those instincts. And here's Ardavan looking into. There were three players lined up, including Oliver Kellogg. That would have been some way to make your name. This is a replay. Oh, it was Jason actually who got the final touch.
Another chance goes begging for Sri Lanka.
Yep, and they don't have much time. Actually, both these sides don't have much time. 7 more minutes to play. Ball knocks the ref and it's a double bounce ball. So I think this is where the urgency kicks in. Both teams have had a fair amount of time to play, and now it's time to actually put on those boosters, play the game. Oliver Kellogg looks like he's taking that role of a midfielder, even though some would say the old school traditional number 9 is in fact a striker. There's a chance for Papua New Guinea, but fortunately that goes begging. Dylan De Silva trying to dribble his way through Manaram Pereira. Now assigned with the duty to take in those throw-ins that Harsha Fernando has been doing all game long. And here's a chance for Sinar Sandesh. Sinar Sandesh has taken up Wasim Razik's place in that formation, so he's acting as the main striker. Chalan Chamira floats it in, and that seems like it's not really out of bounds. Everybody thought it was out of bounds except for Suresh. Dylan De Silva keep doing well to keep it in, and I should really be doing better there.
Unfortunately, another chance goes making for Sri Lanka as we're entering the 86th minute of the game. We're entering that stage where both the teams will hurry up a bit.
Here's Oliver Kelat. Unfortunately, taking too long on the ball to spray that pass out wide. Four more minutes to find something from this game for both sides here at the Racecourse Grounds in the FIFA Series 2024 Sri Lankan edition. There's been quite a number of fans that have turned up here, almost a full house. We're seeing right in front of us, right in front of the commentary box. My sources say that it is almost full upstairs, really. So you can see how passionate Sri Lankans are about this game. It's just that they've been so unlucky during these past years.
The football fraternity of Sri Lanka is very much passionate about their game. They turn up in numbers for school games, especially in Sri Lanka, regardless of which school is playing the game. Schools from Eastern Province, Northern Province, even from Western Province, when there's a matchup, the crowd turns up in numbers to support.
Here's Dylan De Silva trying to make something from this, and he puts in a cross. Doesn't find its way through, and here's a counter-attacking chance for Papua New Guinea. What can they do from here? Well dealt with there with by Sri Lanka. There is an injury sustained by one of the Papua New Guinea players who are on the floor. Referee calling for the medics to come and assist. It's actually the rather new player, Albert Simon, who is on the floor, rather in some big discomfort. Here we can see just launched into him there, crunching tackle by Manaram Pereira.
You call it handoff in rugby?
Absolutely. Body blow, would call it.
As we're approaching the end of the game, it will be interesting to see how much extra time the referee has.
Here's a ball floated in. Dylan De Silva with all the time in the world trying to float one into the box. Well, all this floating, but you'd still wonder who's the first one to sting. Because that's what Dylan De Silva has been doing. That's what Jack Hingbert has been trying to do. He's been putting in the crosses, but just no one on the end of it. Here's Chalan and Chamira trying to do something of his other one, Oliver Kelat, and that's offside. can't actually keep the count of how many offsides that have been there and that's called against Sri Lanka, Akhil.
Just as the first half, the second half too, Sri Lanka has been missing. Some of the very close chances came their way.
Additional time, 5 minutes.
5 minutes additional time added. Since we have completed the 90 minutes of the game. What can we expect in the next 5 minutes?
Well, your guess is good as mine, Akhil. Players are feeling the heat.
You saw on the pictures, president of Sri Lanka football, Jaswar Omar, having a close look at the game.
Yeah, Andy Morrison of Sri Lanka trying to put in a word or two about the Sri Lankan players and what they can do. So next games are actually on Monday. Sri Lanka play Bhutan at 8:45 while Papua New Guinea play Central African Republic at 3 o'clock here at the Racecourse grounds. Of course, all times are Indian Standard Time.
Yellow card there for Manaram Pereira.
Sri Lanka, player number two, Manaram Pereira.
Yeah, suppose it were to end like this, what would you say about Sri Lanka's progress in this game, or rather in the tournament? Would you think that they have a chance against Bhutan?
By the way, Bhutan performed today. Sri Lanka can fancy their chances, but you never know how the game turns up on that particular day.
And I should say that the final substitution for Sri Lanka, that's Mohammed Akib coming on. We did mention that Mohammed Akib, also known as Pfizer, does play for Colombo FC, 21 years old, replacing Ardavan. Ardavan has done his fair share of putting those good crosses into the box, but unfortunately for him and unfortunately for the Sri Lankan outfit, no goal was to be scored.
Mohammed Akib is arguably one of the fastest players in Sri Lanka. So let's see what he can offer in the next 5 minutes of the game.
Too little, too late.
Yes, could be too little, too late as well. And there's a say, better late than never.
Better late than never, of course. There's Mohammed Akib trying to poach his way through. There's Manaram Pereira. Ball ends up again with Papua New Guinea. So suppose that... Suppose that it does stay like this. Would Sri Lanka take heed in knowing that they are facing an opposition who was scored 6 goals against, and the fact that they do keep a clean sheet here, it does hurt them in a way. So would you say that it's beneficial for Sri Lanka to stay this way? And if they do manage to keep a clean sheet, oh, yes, Dylan De Silva still on the ball.
What a game he has had today, Dylan De Silva.
Is he your man of the match?
yeah, Dylan De Silva could be the man of the match. In my point of view, I think you will agree with me as well.
Yeah. Last chance saloon for Sri Lanka. One corner is Manaram Pereira, unfortunately goes into the path of all those Papua New Guinea defenders. Senar Sandesh, what magic can he conjure up from here? Senar Sandesh floats it into the path of Dylan De Silva. And there's a shot on goal. He's just wide off the bar, and that is the final action of this game here at the Racecourse Grounds. Sri Lanka versus PNG Papua New Guinea ends in a draw, and unfortunately for both sides, who did have a good game, there's the last bit of action for Sri Lanka. That would have been amazing if Jude Supan could have kept that under the bar.
What a game it was. Full on full action of some entertaining football throughout 90 minutes. Both the teams tried their level best, especially Sri Lanka on the attack. And the defense of PNG rising up to the occasion. It was a good entertaining football for 90 minutes from both the teams.
The final score is Sri Lanka 0, Papua New Guinea 0. And the player of the match is player number 21, Adhavan Rajamohan from Sri Lanka.
Yeah, Adhavan picks up the player of the match. This is his third match for Sri Lanka. Definitely disappointed Sri Lanka. Fortunately for them, they did have the upper hand during most of the game. The second half started really positively for Papua New Guinea. They did have their chances. Unfortunately for Sri Lanka and its supporters who came out here in drones, it resulted in a 0-0. Coach Andy Morrison just trying to feed his players a bit more knowledge of what he saw from the touchline. Would say that this is a neutral reaction. Coach Andy Morrison did say that he has had a little time to coach the players. Unfortunately, this ended in a draw. But props to Papua New Guinea, Akhil, because they did absorb the pressure. They did do their part. I'm pretty sure Warren Moon, the coach of Papua New Guinea, would be delighted to see this result go as a 0-0 draw.
And also not forgetting the effort by the defense of Papua New Guinea, well led by the captain Ronald Warrison there, with some acrobatic saves and good sportsmanship displayed once again by both the teams. Applauding the crowd, who have been cheering them till 45 past 10 p.m. in the night. This is what we have. This is what the Sri Lankan fans have been waiting for, to witness some entertaining football.
Yeah, if you're a Papua New Guinea fan in Sri Lanka, you know where to be on Monday at 3 p.m. That's at the Racecourse International Stadium, where they will play Central African Republic. Central African Republic, of course, winning 6-0 against Bhutan. And Bhutan will be playing Sri Lanka at 8:45 p.m. at the same venue at Racecourse International Stadium. So from everyone here at Football Sri Lanka, from Akhil, my co-commentator, and myself, Kavinka, it's been a pleasure to watch both the teams go at it. Unfortunately, we didn't have a result. But it's just a friendly. It's supposed to be, or rather, it's not supposed to be results-oriented. It's supposed to be a way to see how that those players can gel together. And I'm pretty sure that Andy Morrison does have his homework to do. Coach Warren Moon does have to study a bit of his side and study that Central African Republic side as well.
It was a good start.
The one that
beat got 3 points.
Bhutan 6-0. I think the advice would be not to be too rushing into the game on Monday. And for Sri Lanka, just take your chances. I think that's what Coach Andy Morrison might be saying to his players. Dylan De Silva had a fine game. Wasim Razik could have had a bit more chances on goal and should have buried some chances as well, Akhil. But unfortunately, nothing doing from that game.
And also Harsha Fernando had a decent game as well. And it was quite a bit of an interesting game where both the teams had the amount of chances and a good entertaining football for the crowd, which turned up in numbers today.
Good evening, Rohan. How do you think about your performance in this opening game?
A bit disappointed. I really think that we deserve the 3 points. We fought very well. All the guys, everyone, even the guys, good fans. But I really think that we deserve the 3 points. Missed a couple of chances, and otherwise a good start of something great.
Yes. So what do you think about the team composition after everyone coming together after some time, for the first time rather in Sri Lanka? How do you think about the team composition?
No, really, I enjoyed everyone that is here, all the players, even the locals, the overseas. Like, we have a great group. There are a lot of players also who didn't make the squad, but who are also there with us. And, you know, it's a thing that we have been working on very long, for almost 2-3 years. And it's a great project. And, you know, there is football in this country. So we have to show it. We know we have it. So, yeah, it's good.
Thank you, Ron. Good luck for the upcoming game against Bhutan. And well played on your performance today.
Thank you, thank you. Thank you, sir.
We have Coach Andy Morrison. Andy Morrison, what do you think about today's game, the 90 minutes?
Look, I want to win as much as anyone, and I'm absolutely gutted that we didn't. I can't ask any more from the players, can't ask any more for the game plan. You know, you try and create opportunities to score. We had 10, 12, 15 chances to score. We didn't take them. Credit to Papua New Guinea for being brave and staying in the game. But we have to win that game of football.
So what do you think about the team composition from players coming from all parts of the world and playing together, I think for the first time in the island nation? So what do you think about the team composition? How did you see that?
I thought they were excellent up until the final moment. We were so good. Patterns, we got in wide areas, we got into the box on numerous occasions. They didn't have a shot on target. So the game plan was perfect, but you have to score goals. You know, when you play a country that are ranked where they are in the world and you play as well as that, you want to come away. You're disappointed. I'm happy to get a clean sheet. But, you know, when I look at where we've come from, the way games have been, Uzbekistan, where we've always tried to just not lose the game, we've been there today. And, you know, with all due respect to them, we've battered them for 90 minutes.
Zani, thank you very much. And look, good luck for the next game. We have the number 14 from Papua New Guinea. What do you think about the 90 minutes today you played here?
It was a tough game. Sri Lanka came out very strong, and we have to put some effort in our defense, and really paid out.
What do you think about the atmosphere in this stadium? A packed crowd. What do you think about that?
It was awesome. Seeing the crowds coming to support was fantastic. Giving that support behind the football is something very nice and inspiring.
Thank you. Good luck for your next game against Central Africa.
Thank you very much.
We have the head coach from Papua New Guinea. What do you think about the 90 minutes your boys played against Sri Lanka?
I was really proud of the performance. A lot of these boys have not had much football in the last 12 weeks. We knew it was going to be a difficult test, and Sri Lanka certainly tested us. And look, I can see what Sri Lankan football is doing and how you're building seven new faces tonight, all from overseas. Made it really difficult for us. There's real quality in that team. I'm just so proud of our defensive effort tonight. And like I said, if that's us coming off a break for 12 weeks and having a two-week training camp, then for me, Papua New Guinea football is only on the up if we can get them right for the Nations Cup in June.
What do you think about the conditions and the atmosphere here at the Racecourse International Stadium?
No, look, the conditions are what they are. It's humid, which, you know, our boys are used to that. We come from a hot climate. The pitch obviously got some rain and it made it a bit difficult, but it wasn't too bad. The pitch still played really well. And we got tested. Like I said, Sri Lanka's a very good football side now with the players you've brought in. And we had to be on our best game for 90 minutes and concentrated. And look, at times rode our luck, but saying that, we could have pinched it as well. We had a couple of half chances at the end. So we're really pleased with that performance.
Thank you, coach. Good luck for your next game.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
So, after a very successful comeback, may I interview back on it? No interview?
As you see on the screen, the highlight package of that interesting game which took place between host Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea of FIFA Series 2024. As you see on the screen, Dylan De Silva having a fair bit of chances in the first half. Unfortunately, couldn't convert into a goal. There you go, the third chances Dylan De Silva had in the first half. The chances in the second half, Sri Lanka had very close opportunities for Sri Lanka throughout the second half as well. Unfortunately, Vasin Razik heading out, missing out on a header there, and the corner kick cleanly collected there. The most closest chance Sri Lanka had in the game was where the free kick of Adon Rajmohan, saved by the goalkeeper, the captain of Papua New Guinea. Wrap up proceedings, Chalna Chamira there. That was the highlights of the match between host Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea. Today's results: Central African Republic winning 6-0 against Bhutan in the opening game of FIFA Series, Sri Lankan edition. And Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea are ending up in a new all,
So, ladies and gentlemen, after a very successful comeback between Sri Lanka and Papua New Guinea, we have come to the end of this beautiful day, the opening day of the FIFA Mini Series 2024. So, congratulations to the first team to win the match, the Central African Republic. And today we don't have a winner to the second match yet. On Monday, we'll join you with a new venture, starting the matches between Central African Republic and Papua New Guinea. And in the evening, we are going to join with Sri Lanka and Bhutan. Until then, stay tuned with us on SBC Live. Thank you.